What's up, kids, boys, girls, adults, grandparents? This is your favorite international local zombie buddy, pal, acquaintance, friend, BFF, enemy, newbie, zombie friend, Zombie Sam. Got another zombie rant for you. I don't know if most of you guys even like this shit, what I say about these movies, but fuck, I don't give a shit, really. For those of you that do, thank you very much. I almost dropped the DVD. And I have a lot of movies to get through, man. I have a lot of Region 2, so I gotta find myself another DVD player to get to. I'm almost done with all of my American versions, so I'm gonna be fucked after a while unless I get that, like, pronto. But anyways, that's talking about the future. We're talking about now. Now is the George A. Romero Survival of the Dead. Very fucking good film. I was very surprised by it. I had this on my wish list on Amazon for a couple months. It was like 10 something plus shipping and handling. Found it at a small video store in Claremont, California for $2.99. That video store is called Video Paradiso. So they have a tons of shit. Look it up online. They're connected to Rhino Records. If you guys are interested, I think they might send shit out too. So Rhino Records, Video Paradiso. Boom, that's where I got it from. Anyways, I have some shit written down because I watched this a day and a half ago and my fucking memory's all fucked. I have some shit to talk about. The main characters are Sarge and his right-hand man, Kenny. I don't have the real actors' names written. I'm trying to make these short and sweet, you know. They're a part of a National Guard troop that kind of, like, left their post. This movie takes place after Diary of the Dead, which I haven't seen yet. I actually do have. I think I do. So I should have watched that first, but whatever. Their troop consists of Sarge, Kenny, Tomboy, which Tomboy, she is fucking hot. Her name's, I got her name. Her name's Athena Carcanis, or Carcanis? Probably Carcanis. But God, I love a tomboy, man. I don't know those of you who don't know, but I do. I love tomboys, man. Those are my favorite type of meat. Anyways, another dude named Cisco. They meet up with... They're taking off from the post. They meet up. They run into a character named Boy. He's a young guy, obviously. He tells them about an island called Plum Island where there's refuge, I guess, you know? So, something about that island is there's two Irish families on there that are feuding from, like, way back in the days. The O'Flynns and the Muldoons. The head of the families are Seamus Muldoon and Patrick O'Flynn. Those are the two main heads, the two old dudes, you know? The guys that are in charge of all that shit. They got tons of followers with them too, but I don't got all their names down. I really don't give a shit about them. So anyways, they hide. Well, this kid takes them to where there's a fucking dock, and just in the beginning of the movie, Patrick O'Flynn gets basically banned from the island because his idea is like, let's just kill all the fucking zombies. Fuck them. Let's kill them. So that way none of us will ever die. We won't get caught up in all this shit. But Seamus wants to fucking save all their lives and make sure that this disease can be cured and maybe we can take care of them later on and whatnot. So he wants to save their lives and he has them, like, chained up everywhere and shit. So they don't like the way Patrick's going about killing everybody. So they ban him from the island. They set him on a fucking dinghy out to where he runs into Boy and the National Guard people. They're about to hijack a ferry when they start getting blasted on by Patrick O'Flynn and them. They overtake them. They get in the fucking ferry. Patrick jumps on there and they're going, like, okay, let's go to Plum Island. That's where he's from, so I can get back over there. They really don't know the background what happened to him, so they're like, fuck it, let's go. He seemed like a badass dude, you know? So when they get back over there, Patrick's daughter, Janet, was still running around over there. They get there and they see her running around a fucking zombie farm on a horse. And they're like, holy shit, you know, like, because most of the other zombies they had on the island were going about their daily routines. They had them chained up to, like, a fucking hole, and they're, like, hole in the dirt. And then they had another mailman zombie chained up to a mailbox, and he would just walk away, walk back in, put the mail back in, walk away. And it was just, like, their mind was set on what they used to do, I guess. So this chick ran around on a fucking horse, and they're like, oh, shit, your daughter's fucking dead, you know? This whole time... well, they find out that it's not that Janet, it's her twin sister. I forgot her goddamn name. So, during as the movie goes through, they run into the Muldoons, and they have, like, shootouts and shit, and they're trying to, like, hide from them, and all this bullshit's going on. They're trying to figure out an alternative food for the zombies, because they're thinking, well, we can find something for them to eat, so that way they won't eat us, and we can, like, train them to fucking eat this fucking animals and shit. And it's pretty fucked up, because, like, at the end of the movie, they kind of have a big shootout. Fucking, Patrick Wilson ends up getting fucking shot in the stomach, and he's like, oh, fuck, I'm gonna die. And then his daughter had just went up to the, they had, like, her twin sister, like, in the little place where they corral the horses and shit. She went up to her, and she was like, oh, look at, she's in a fucking, she took a bite out of the fucking horse. And she was like, look, guys, look what happened. And they didn't know what the fuck's going on. She walked over. The sister comes and bites her in her fucking hand. And she's like, you fucking bitch. You fucking bit me, you know? Shoot her in the fucking head. Then Patrick is like, oh, shit, my daughter's bit. She's going to fucking die. Tells the other guy, the Muldoon's like, dude, give me a moment. Let's just squash it. Give me a moment with my daughter. He walks away. And fucking Seamus Muldoon just blasts that dude right in the back. And he's like, fuck, he's all fucked, and everyone starts shooting at each other. The National Guard, oh, and Cisco, the dude has been all over on that tomboy chick, because she's like, they show her, like, fucking masturbating and shit like that. It's pretty crazy. She's pretty smoking hot. Oh, goddamn. I have a fucking deal with her. But anyways, Cisco, the whole time, has been telling her, like, oh, he wants her. He gets fucking bit, and he dies. She has to shoot him in the head. It's kind of fucked up. But anyways, the whole rest of the troop, they start taking off. They're saying, fuck this, we're gonna get the fuck out of here. They're, like, running through the forest, and then, so, the daughter gets up during all this shit, and she's like, fuck, I gotta tell these people that my sister actually took a bite out of the horse and ate it, and that's showing signs of them conforming to, like, hey, let's eat these fucking animals instead, you know? So she's running to them, telling them, oh, I gotta fucking, because she's gonna change pretty soon. She got bit, and the dad's gonna change pretty soon, because he got shot. And as the dad got shot, he turned around and everyone else blasted fucking Seamus Muldoon. So they're both gonna be fucked. They're gonna both change too, you know? So they show the troop, the other National Guard, running away, trying to get back to the ferry. That chick comes up, she's like, hey guys, I got something to tell you. We found the cure. I mean, not the cure, but we found the way out. She's like, yeah, the fucking boom, and the dad just blasts in her fucking head. Before she could even tell them that, don't worry about it, the zombies are conforming, they're beating the animals. So, fucking dad fucked them. I'm at 8 minutes. So anyways, that's how it ends, basically. And then at the end of the movie, the fucking National Guard, they get out of there. Fucking, at the end, they show a big hill. They show Seamus Muldoon and Patrick O'Flynn, zombies, walking up to each other. And they just both pull up the gun, and they're like, fuck. Just shooting that, pulling the trigger, and, like, that's what they're just so used to feeding their zombie bodies even do it, too. So, it's a fucking good movie. Survival of the Dead. Go fucking buy it. I only got, like, a minute left. I bought it for $2.99. I'm pretty sure you guys can find it for cheap also. It's a great buy. Really cool zombies. Really cool cast. I enjoyed it. Buy that shit. Peace.